Oh, Chloe's alive.
We got no time for this shit. Come on, Max. Chloe! Jesus, dude, what is up with you?
I'm just glad we're here together.
I guess you need to talk. No worries. It's all good.
I'm glad you're with me, too. What's going on, Max? We have to find Nathan right now. He's gonna
sorry, Warren.
To Rachel. Let's go. Now. Chloe, wait. Listen. I can walk and listen, okay?
Stop and listen for once.
Fine, Max. I'm listening.
Chloe, you can't go in that party. You're gonna die if you do.
You used your powers, right? And you fucked around with time and I died.
Not like that.
You're supposed to back me up. So there's no way that punk-ass bitch Nathan Prescott is taking me down.
You're right, he won't. Mark Jefferson killed you. And others.
Jefferson, the art teacher? That's bullshit! Nathan is the fucking serial killer! We saw the proof! Now excuse me, I'm going to that party to make sure he never hurts anybody again. Are you coming?
Nathan is dead, and you're in danger.
That fucker is already dead? How do you know that?
Because I was there.
Will you please tell me exactly what happened? Please.
Chloe. Jefferson drugged and kidnapped me. I was tied up in his bunker. You have no idea what hell I went through to get back here. But I couldn't let you die. You brought me back here, and I can't lose you again. I won't.
Max, I'm so sorry. I was the one who dragged you into all this shit. Nobody, especially you, should have to go through that. Now we have to stop Jefferson. With one bullet.
No, not this way. Chloe, I can't keep fixing everything if all I'm gonna do is just break it over and over again. I know how this is gonna turn out, and I'm afraid I'm fucking up all these alternate realities.
Wait, alternate realities? What do you mean, Max? What did you do?
I think we need to get her to save, if we can, to get her, because we can't leave this little bubble we're in. Should we tell her to get Victoria? Like, she and Victoria need to get out of here, badly.
I fucked up, Chloe. I wanted to make things right, but everything turned out wrong.
Max, what the hell are you talking about?
I was able to go back in time to the last day William was alive. I stopped him from leaving, but you ended up in a car crash instead.
You saw my dad again?
You were completely paralyzed. And you were in pain. You were slowly dying, and you asked me to end your life. I did. For you. I didn't want you to suffer in any other timeline or reality. I couldn't bear the thought of you in any more pain.
God, Max. That must have been awful for you. I'm so sorry I had to ask you that.
It was worse for you. But I had no idea what would happen, and as usual, I messed everything up, and I never want to hurt you. Ever. You have to believe me.
Of course I do. Do you think I would even know how to handle that situation? Nobody would. The important thing is that we're together again.
You're right. That's why you should come with me, so we can stay together and stay alive.
I hear you, Max, but do you think we should let Jefferson get away with torture and murder?
Of course not. If we tell David, he'll believe us and he can actually stop him. Right?
I don't get it. Why do you trust him after you totally reamed him the other day? He's not even at our house anymore.
Chloe, David saved me from Jefferson. If he didn't track down the darkroom, I'd be dead right now.
Max, I had no clue. I should have been the one to save you, but I'm so grateful David was there. So what's your plan?
We tell him everything, including that Victoria is in danger.
Okay. You've been through so much. I believe you, Max. After all, I'm still your faithful companion.
Yes, you are. So listen, in a few minutes, I won't know any of this happened. Nothing. We absolutely have to stay in your room and do nothing. Then we explain everything to David, and we finally let him do his job. You'll have to tell me exactly what I did and said just now. Just explain that I traveled through time using the photo.
Will you believe me?
I'll always believe you, Chloe.
And tell him to bring backup, because Jesus Christ, he is not good with one guy against a tripod. Oh, what happened? So Chloe's not dead, right? What about Victoria? I guess we're just gonna let Nathan die, because we're not far- he's probably dead right now. Oh yes, he brought backup this time. So much better. He's so bad at taking that guy out on his own. But what do we do with- we still haven't solved the storm. We just brought Chloe back.
Oh! Chloe! I see that the real Max is back. So, how was your time trip, dude?
Shut up. Oh, you're alive. You're alive. Oh, both of us. I did so much to bring you back, Chloe. It worked. Actually worked. You're with me again. Looks like even fate doesn't want us apart. And I traveled through multiple realities just to save my ungrateful ass over and over. And I hope it was worth it. I don't blame you for wanting me out of your life after all my drama. Come on. I'm the official drama king and queen of Arcadia Bay this week. Just look at what my powers have caused in just a short time. Nobody. You're Max fucking Caulfield, time warrior. Even if you weren't, you're kind and caring. Nobody could have a better boss. Nobody. You didn't ask for any of this to happen, but it did. You need to accept how awesome you are. Maybe I willed it subconsciously to myself. I always wanted my life to be special. An adventure. But not without you. And it didn't happen until I moved back here. So, without you, my powers wouldn't even exist. And for whatever scientific, mystical reason that we'll obviously never figure out, we were meant to be together at this exact moment in history. I have to think that Rachel was somewhere behind the scenes, fighting for justice. I'd like to think that, too. We all owe Rachel Amber. Now tell me everything that happened. You remember, right?
Well, we left the party and made sure Jefferson couldn't find us. For once, I was glad I lived in an actual fortress. Then the storm got hella crazy, and you said we would be safe at the lighthouse.
Chloe, look. The storm is getting bigger now. It's coming closer. I can't even believe this is real. This is happening because of me.
Stop it. Just stop beating yourself up, okay? We both paid our dues already on it. God, look at that. Look at that monster. Who knows? This could be Rachel's revenge. Our revenge. The lighthouse is out of the way of the tornado. Come on!
What? Chloe.
I've got your back, Max.
Oh. Whoa.
Alfred Hitchcock famously called film little pieces of time.
What?
I'm back in class. Photography,
as he
what the hell?
These pieces of time can frame us in our glory. And
I have to listen to this Jefferson lecture again.
Shadow,
this might be hell.
Chiaroscuro. Now, can you give me an example of a photographer
okay,
who perfectly
this
captured
is messed
the human condition
up.
In black and white?
Am I stuck in a time loop?
Anybody? Bueller?
Diane Arbus.
Be calm and
there you go,
don't
Gloria.
Freak out.
Why Arbus?
Yet.
Because of her images of hopeless faces.
Sound.
Totally haunted by the eyes of those sad mothers.
Whoa.
She saw humanity as tortured,
wait,
right?
What's going on?
And frankly, it's bullshit.
Nobody even cares?
Shh, shh, shh. Keep that to yourself.
I think this is a nightmare. I think I'm just... this is a nightmare. This isn't real.
In a moment of desperation.
What the hell?
Everybody's gone now.
Everybody's gone to the
Have
rapture?
I totally fucked up time? This doesn't make sense.
I think we're fine, Max. I think you're having a nightmare when you passed out.
Oh, that's too creepy.
Yeah, I'm going with nightmare. I think you're freaking out because you passed out. Because this is the worst thing that could happen, is you reset everything again and get the opportunity to ruin it again.
I'm sorry, Kate. Not yet, you bastard.
Max, if you're reading this, it means you're dead. Mr. Jefferson, hugs and kisses! Unfortunately, she is dead. And she is dead. And I've seen him die, too. A lot of people have died. I've seen Max be like a millimeter from death like 10 times now. Anything over here? Do I try to leave? There's no barrier this time, so it's not a photo flashback.
Rachel didn't deserve any of this.
Holy shit. It's a photo of us digging up the body. Yeah, this is totally a nightmare.
Oh no.
Yeah, why do we think that the lighthouse is going to be safe? Didn't we see the lighthouse collapse in episode 1? This seems like a bad plan. I thought we had a vision of that.
I'm not going to take the bait. I'm not.
Is Max Caulfield a loser? Does she hurt everyone she helps? Yes. Everyday zeros. Max has already won, because she has already lost. So don't bother to enter. What's the last bit say?
I'm not going to take the bait. I'm not.
Mr. Jefferson's thumbs up. One rubbish sponsor. And it's just loser and zero all over the background. Saturation.
I see you, Max Caulfield. Don't even think about leaving here until we talk about your entry.
Find scissors. Take them out right now.
I just wanted to know if you'd like to spend the rest of your life in my darkroom. Your purity inspires me so much, and we could be so happy together. Who needs selfies when I can give you portraiture?
There's no way I'm saying that. No way.
Wow. There are no good options here. This is definitely a nightmare.
I've been dreaming of the day when you would finally tell me. I love you, Mr. Jefferson.
Call me Mark. We need to play catch up on all the time we've wasted. Especially since there's nobody left in your life. I love you too, Max.
And he's gone again.
This can't be real. I don't believe it.
We're having a bad day. Night. Storm. Decade. Oh, that's trippy. We walked directly from the classroom to the dorm. That's a neat trick. It's always cool when a video game makes a door do what it's not supposed to do. Oh shit. It was Kate. It's Kate. Will bang for Jesus. Kate's crying at her own funeral. Her own shrine.
Hey, Kate. Max. How could you let me jump off a roof? You're the only person I trusted here. But you never really listened to me. Now I'm never going to heaven. Instead, you've stuck me in hell. Alone forever.
No! Kate, I was only trying to save you.
Jesus Christ, game. Who do you have left to show me? So we can't save Kate at this point, or Nathan. Is it still accurate?
Gotta be a key here. Find it.
Well, that loops. We have to find, let's see. Max is on the right after the girl's bathroom. Maybe I have to go to my own room. To the selfie again or something?
Never mind me, officer. I'm just here to see what popular's keys.
Nope. That didn't amount to much. Oops, sorry. There we go. Trying to remember the fast-moving button. Bathroom? Okay. We're looping. End of the hallway. Maybe Victoria?
Oh, is that all? Oh, well, why didn't you just tell me? How about I just give you the keys to my RV while I'm at it?
Who's this one? Not gonna help me anyway. You know what? We'll just try them all for a little bit. They can't be wrong forever, can they? Or are they all wrong? Let's try Victoria's room.
This hall never ends. I better find something.
Victoria, I think?
Okay, where did you last put those keys?
Huh. Is there a clue over here? Anything highlighted? 219, 220, 211, 212, 223. The numbers don't seem weird. TV lounge vending. Can I go backwards? Alright, this is getting weird. Bathroom? Wait, that's... Is that a second bathroom? Oh, the other one's showers, huh? I was gonna say, why is there multiple bathrooms right next to each other? We already tried her room, and that one, and this one. Is there a clue over here? Window. Climb out the window. That's a whale. There's a giant whale outside the dorm. Oh, and there's one on top of the floor there. The forks. That orange is terrified of forks. Look for clues. Can you swim to success? What room have I not tried yet? Uh-oh. Is it the candles? Is there a specific sequence of candles around? Oh, key. 218. That's on this side, right? What? Oh. Hello. Do I need a key again? Not there.
Rachel Amber. She was my angel. After my dad died and he moved, I felt abandoned. Rachel saved my life. So Rachel took my place. I'm glad she was there for you. 6 months ago, she just left Arcadia. Without a word. Without me. How do you...
The TV lounge is circled now? What's going on there?
Maybe she disappeared. Maybe she wanted to start a totally new life. Unlike you, she would have told me, okay? Something happened to her. Before Rachel left, she said she met somebody who changed her life. Then poof.
There's posters everywhere. Do I try 18 again?
Do you think that Rachel and I would have been friends?
You're not that different. She has a great eye for images and for art. Plus, she's a smartass like you. We would all be hella best friends forever.
I'm getting some PT flashbacks right now. How am I gonna get out of here?
I miss Rachel too.
Where's the key?
The thing I Principal Wells told me about what you said happened in the bathroom.
A key or a clue? My room?
Sounds like you totally crushed on Rachel.
You would have too.
Smart, sexy, and sassy.
Like me, right?
Well, maybe Rachel...
218's not moving or anything. I'm missing something here. I'm missing something.
Jesus, she was banging that head break! Bitch lied to my face, Max! I can't trust anybody again.
I wonder if Rachel has a room around here.
Until they got.
Is there a Rachel room? Rachel Amber, right here on the left.
Max Caulfield. I knew Max was jealous of Rachel.
Oh shit, I'm a Victoria. So what about Victoria's room then? Max again? Oh, now my selfies are all over the wall. Look at me, I'm Max Selfie. The no girl bathroom. A lot of Max Selfie stuff going on here. Everything's backwards, even the main theme of the game. What in the world? Everyone's... Even the text prompts are backwards. Are you just telling me to go backwards by playing backwards? Do I go backwards through here? Alright, you're freaking me out a little bit. Oh, hello. Do I just go to where we saved Chloe? Maybe that's what's going on here. Oops. I'm just trying to feel a little uncomfortable right now. Chloe! We just gotta save Chloe again. Oh my god, the spirit animals are back.
Don't try to hide, Max! Get over here! Let me capture you!
Okay, now the nightmare's getting a little silly.
Coming after me again.
You used to be so pure, so innocent. Now, you have to die.
Now we're having a nightmare again about our fear of Jefferson.
Please understand, Max. The only place I can be myselfie is in the dark room.
There more than one of him? What's that light? There he is.
What happened to your spark, Max? I thought I could be.
Maybe I'll be safe in the lighthouse. Maybe I'll wake up.
Where is this one going? Did he go somewhere else now? There he is. Gotta hide over here.
Now you'll never be an artist. Much less a photographer.
Come here, Max. Class is dismissed.
If only Metal Gear was this easy. Oh.
Jefferson. I miss those days when you looked at me in class with those wide eyes. I want to be your professor again. I can teach you so much.
He's officially creepy. Is that just a spinning Jefferson? What the hell? Get behind the painting of my... Ah, it's a picture of myself that I gotta hide behind.
Good evening, Blackwell. This is Principal Wells. And I'm here to drop the mic on Max Caulfield.
Just gotta keep rotating counter... Oh, crap.
Max.
Why are you moving so slow, Max?
I wonder how we'll get around this.
Oh wait, I can rewind time. This is not even a threat.
Attention! I regret to announce...
Yeah, she does not move very quickly. Even in fast mode.
That one of your fellow classmates, Maxine Caulfield, has died under tragic circumstances that I promise to investigate after I get my drink.
They're all the same, they're all the freaky pictures of all the, family that died.
Max, come out to play. Come out to play.
He would do the Warriors reference. Mr. Movie.
Max!
Oopsie. I timed that wrong. I thought he was turning.
If I found out.
Hey, babe, babe! Who wants to go ape? Go ape, go ape, babe!
Max?
Leave me alone. Go away. Go back over there. There you go.
Sick David Max.
Do you have a scarf I can borrow, Max?
Red forever?
Hey, Max.
She will always hate you!
Ironic that I ended up being right about everything, Max.
Go away, Nathan. I'm busy. Got things to do.
Excuse me, Max.
Damn it! There's so many of them. Oh, whoa.
Cheat life. And cheat your friends out of life.
Poor Kate Marsh. Max might as well have pushed her ass off that roof. Poor Sam.
Hey, Max. Pretty fucking ironic that I ended up being right about everything, and you end up destroying the town.
You're just jealous because me and Victoria actually do the work while you do nothing and whine.
Hey, Max. Please, come here.
Hey, Max.
Hey, Max. Please, come here.
The junkyard. Oh, wow, everyone is here. It's like we're externalizing her anxieties with every single person in the area. Her fears regarding everyone in town. He's really creepy.
Oh no. Bottles. This might be hell.
Damn, they're all here. Nathan.
Nobody ever helped me, Max. Especially you.
Max!
Especially you.
I'd be a lot happier.
There's some serious coverage here. Damn.
Now that Rachel.
Looks like there are still bottles to find. Oh, joy.
I'm supposed to find bottles to continue? Why do the bottles matter? What? This is some demented end of Metal Gear Solid 2 stuff going on right now.
Dare question the chef.
Right, like you're the real cook here?
I am, when your mom's away.
I'll let her know that.
Hello? Hey, honey. Just making a fabulous breakfast with Chloe and Max. We're all going to work at the Two Winds. What? Oh, I didn't know you had to get groceries. Of course I'll come pick you up. Now I'll have an excuse to get a mocha. Be there shortly. Love you. Excuse me, ladies. I have to go rescue yonder queen at the Save Mart. She doth have many bags of delicious grub for us
you
to feast upon.
You are ridiculous.
You'll be grateful for that someday. Shit, where are my keys?
That's $1 for the swear jar.
You mean your college fund. Keys, please. Shit, where are those keys?
Another $1 for the swear jar!
You're bankrupting me! Aha! You can't hide from me forever! Now lock up after I leave. Play nice. Try not to destroy too much of the house. And no Chloe and Max wine tasting session.
Dad!
Hey, Max. Would you say hi to Chloe and Joyce? Don't forget to remind them that you let me die. This is fucked up. They're using this entire snow globe thing as a metaphor for the fact that all I can do is watch and I can't change anything. Joyce, Max, we have surveillance video of you overdosing Chloe. You cannot escape now. There is no reality where you can hide now. Don't you dare underestimate me, you hear? Pompidou? Bitch, do not mess with Frank or me. You got a snack? Rachel. Hi, Max. Rachel Amber here. Just wanted to introduce myself. I'll be seeing you soon. Real soon. Nathan. Max, I loved your photo shoot with Jefferson. He absolutely captured you. If you want, we can hang out and get high. Good evening, young Max. The squirrels talk to me. But how can you? Samuel has no phone. Because nothing makes sense here. The dog's bitch talking me. This is the world we're in now. The people who made this game played Metal Gear Solid 2, and they wanted to get in on that action.
How long will this nightmare go on?
Now I'm wearing less clothes. Max, you need to wake up.
I think you'd be perfect for my new photo series on retro grunge. You have the same qualities that I loved in Rachel Amber, but not Max.
Max is a fucking child.
Oh, Christ, I know. And she never shuts up, does she?
I'm so over her hipster bullshit.
I think everyone at Blackwell is over Max. Let's prove it.
Holy shit, Warren. Max is trying to play us both.
I guess she's not as innocent as she acts.
Not when she's trying to hook up with both of us.
I only want to go ape with you, Chloe. Come here.
God damn, you are a sexy bitch. Why hang out with Max, huh?
Boredom. Plus, she's like my personal puppet.
I hear that. Do you want a party? I got a drugstore in my room.
Oh shit, look at Max spying on us. Take a fucking picture, bitch. Or take a selfie. See, this is how you bust a move, Max. No mosh pit for you, shaka bra. Damn, Victoria. You're a real woman. Not a little girl like Max.
I fucking love your tats, Chloe. You're so hot. I can't believe it took us so long to hook up.
I don't even know what my life is anymore.
Why did you get rewind powers? You don't even know how to use them. Rachel's dead and you're still alive. Life is so not fair. I wish she would have never come back to Arcadia Bay. You're the real Storm.
Am I back? Now where am I? Bathroom keypad. What? There's a keypad on this side of the door?
I'll be so grateful if this is the last digicode.
Oh man. Oh! Oh.
Great. Numbers are all over the place. How will I find the right code?
I'm starting to get the sneaking suspicion that they ran out of story to tell, so they're like, what if the game freaks out for like a half an hour or an hour, and then it'll feel like there was a full episode? Which I kind of get to some extent, because Walking Dead has similar oh, there's only one in the mirror. That's neato. 11:30. No? Is it 11:30? It's backwards. It's 0311, right, because it's a mirror. But yeah, like I think of like the Walking Dead season 1. The season episode 5 was weirdly short. Because they were just out of stuff to do at that point. And so I wonder if I can almost see them being like, how do we make our finale longer? Puzzle sections. Freaky dream. So, 0311. First try. What happens if you fail 3 times like before?
Don't kill us, Max!
I guess I'll never dance again, Max.
Right when I was about to start a new life in California.
Look, I know things were bad between us, but that doesn't mean I deserve to die.
Max, I hope you do the right thing. I hope.
I can't believe you kissed me.
I always thought of you like a daughter.
Now you're going to kill me?
And now you're going to take me away from my family. Why would you do that?
Max, you're exactly the kind of soldier I'd want by my side in a war.
Son of a bitch, this is gonna hurt.
Yep. Max is totally gonna die soon. That's what's gonna happen.
So this is how Max gets her revenge on.
Like I told you
honey,
before.
Honey, I always thought old of you like a daughter.
Never die.
And now you're gonna take
break her, break her.
Now.
Thanks for saving me and carrying
what
the load, good buddy.
My husband and
that's
new
a
baby.
Big 10-4.
We'll have to go without me.
Don't let
Max,
the squirrels die.
I hope you can live with yourself
I
after
wish
this.
We had been friends, Max. But please, don't let me die like this. I'm still a teenager.
What?
Please, Max, don't kill me so we can finally have our tea session.
You've always had my back, and now you're going to let me die? Thanks, Max.
Max, I think we might have to die.
Who are you? Holy shit, are you serial? I'm you, dumbass. Or I'm one of many Maxes you've left behind. Can you get me out of here? Oh, so you want help? Thought you could control everybody and everything, huh? Twist time around your fingers? I tried to help. I only wanted to do the right thing. No, you only wanted to be popular. And once you got these amazing powers, your big plan was to trick people into thinking you give a rat's ass.
I do care. That's why I was trying to make friends.
By telling people what they want to hear? You were just looking for a shortcut because you can't make friends on your own.
That's not true. I have great friends, and I've used my powers for good.
Please, stop playing innocent. You're a goddamn hypocrite. You've left a trail of death and suffering behind you.
That was not my fault, you son of a bitch.
Don't you dare talk about our mom that way. What about the crap that was your fault?
Wait, let me guess. You fucked up time and space for your precious punk Chloe? You think she's worth all that? We all are. This isn't about Chloe, or even me anymore.
Gosh, you're so selfless now, Mahatma Max. It's too bad you pissed your power away on high school drama.
Chloe does a better job of guilt-tripping me than you do.
Because you let her bully you. It's called Stockholm Syndrome. But you didn't do that homework, so you'll have to learn the hard way. Like Rachel.
Just shut up. You're not scaring me anymore.
I'd be more worried about Chloe killing us than Jefferson.
Max, do you really think she's our friend? That she respects us in any way? Man, you are so stupid. I'm embarrassed to have the same name. And someday Chloe will destroy... Oh, hell, speak of the devil.
Dude, do not even fuck with her head. She knows what we went through together this week, and you don't. There's no way you can break up our team. This is reality.
After 5 years, you're still Max Caulfield.
I am seriously glad to see you.
Welcome home, Max. Fasten your seatbelt.
Whoa. All right, we're back in here. Oh, okay, we did change places. I thought that was all. I thought we were still riding the what happened for me sitting on the bench, and that was, and I was back in the same place.
I know it was your birthday last month. This was my real father's camera. I want you to have it.
Yes, of course it's cool. Thank you. This camera is so sweet.
Now that we got that mushy shit out of the way, I feel like stage diving. Let's thrash this place. Yep, I'm fucking insane in the brain. Let's dance! Shake that bony white ass. Or take my picture with your new camera. This song fucking rules. This song fucking rules. Can't dance, hippie? Come on. Rock out, girl!
Yo, turn it off! Turn it off! You need to hide now. My stepdad will kill me if he finds you here.
You were here today, Max. You saved me. I'm still tripping on that. Seeing you after all these years feels like...
destiny.
If this is destiny, I hope we can find Rachel. I miss her, Max. What the hell is this?
Snowflakes? Or a storm is coming?
Let's talk about your superpower. Epic! I pledge allegiance to Max and the power for which she stands. You can rewind time, Max. That's fucking insane. We have to play.
You need a sidekick to guide you.
Okay, Girl Wonder. Show me the way to Chloe's cave.
This life-size wax figure diorama is freaking me out.
Welcome to American Rust, my home away from hell.
Raw and rough. It suits you.
Max, do you know how awesome this is? I get my best friend back, and she's also super-sized?
I don't feel so super.
Max, here, let me help you find a place to chill. You freaked me out there. Do you feel any better now? You saved me again! Crazy! Now we're totally bonded for life. Since you're the mysterious superhero, I'll be your faithful chauffeur and companion.
My powers might not last, Chloe.
That's okay. We will. Forever.
One of us is gonna die. You can't set up the story like this and not have one of these characters die at this point.
I'm so glad you're my partner in crime.
As long as you're my partner in time. I might get on the other side of that door before you, Lupin.
The race is on. See you soon. Welcome to my domain.
You are magic! I have no clue how that... Max, you better come check out these files.
It's not a drawing. Look. Rachel in the dark room. Rachel in the dark room. Over and over.
Cowabunga! Why, look, an otter in my water. Your power is changing everything, Max. Especially you. I can already...
Let's call it a draw. I'm gonna freeze my ass off when I get out.
You look cute with your hair soaked in chemicals.
Hide! Hide! You can't go back to your dorm now. You're a Blackwell fugitive. Crash at my place tonight.
Photobomb!
Photo hog. It feels like a different world from yesterday.
We left a skid mark on Blackwell last night.
I wish we could just hang out all morning like we used to. Maybe we should get up. I have to get back to Blackwell soon.
I double dare you. Kiss me now. Damn, you're hardcore, Max. Now I can text Warren and tell him he doesn't stand a chance. Unless he's into girl-on-girl action. Oh, we could cruise everywhere in this bad boy. Can you see us heading down the coast to Big Sur and beyond? I know. Just daydreaming. That makes me ill that Rachel posed like this for Frank. I wrote him love letters. I can't believe she was banging Frank. Rachel straight up lied to my face. Why didn't she say anything?
Because she knew how you would react.
And she wasn't much of a friend, huh? Just another person who shits all over me. Why does everybody in my life let me down? Not until I see it first! You know the rules, Dad!
Dude, I am so lucky that my father is cool.
Max, you are being so fucking strange. You feel okay?
Chloe, I am awesome! We are awesome!
It's weird hanging out with you again.
I know. I'm glad we are, though.
Look, the worst thing you can do is treat me like a baby. I still want to laugh and talk shit with my best friend. Can we stop?
I
This is seriously the best view of the sunset. What do photographers call that?
The golden hour.
Seeing them looking at the sunset, but instead it's their own childhood. They set that up on purpose.
Whoa, awesome picture. We look so badass in our pirate gear.
We should have taken over Arcadia Bay when we had the chance.
Listen, Max. My respiratory system is failing, and it's only getting worse. I've heard the doctors talking about it when they thought I was zonked out. So, I know I'm just putting off the inevitable while my parents suffer along, and I will too.
Chloe! You're back! I'm so glad you're here.
You sound high, but thanks for the morning grope. Since we were up all night playing CSI Arcadia Bay, I was still spaced out here trying to put all this info together.
Kate wasn't the first. All those binders are filled with other victims. Victoria has to be next. Nathan must be planning to dose her tonight at the Vortex Club party.
Rachel. This can't be real.
Rachel! Oh, Rachel, no, no, please not her! Chloe. Rachel, why? I'm sorry, Chloe. I'm so sorry. I loved her so much. How can she be dead? What kind of world does this? Who does this? Come on, Max. We're almost there. Almost there. Please wake up. Wake up. Max, come on now. Don't worry. Don't worry. We'll be okay. Max, Max, can you hear me? Please say something.
Chloe, I must have passed out.
Oh, thank God. Don't you ever do that again, okay?
I swear. But that nightmare was so real. It was so horrible. This is my storm. I caused this. I caused all of this. I changed fate and destiny so much that I actually did alter the course of everything. And all I really created was just death and destruction.
Fuck all that, okay? You were given a power. You didn't ask for it. And you saved me, which had to happen. All of this did. Except for what happened to Rachel. But without your power, we wouldn't have found her. Okay, so you're not the goddamn Time Master, but you're Maxine Caulfield. And you're amazing. Max. This is the only way.
I feel like I took the shot 1,000 years ago.
You could use that photo to change everything right back to when you took that picture. All that would take is for me to
fuck that. No, no way. You are my number one priority now. You are all that matters to me.
I know. You prove that over and over again. Even though I don't deserve it. I'm so selfish. Not like my mom. Look what she had to give up and live through. And she did. She deserves so much more than to be killed by a storm in a fucking diner. Even my stepfather deserves her alive. There's so many more people in Arcadia Bay who should live. Way more than me.
Don't say that. I won't trade you.
You're not trading me. Maybe you've just been delaying my real destiny. Look at how many times I've almost died or actually died around you. Look at what's happened in Arcadia Bay ever since you first saved me. I know I've been selfish, but for once, I think I should accept my fate. Our fate, Chloe. Max, you finally came back to me this week, and you did nothing but show me your love and friendship. You made me smile and laugh like I haven't done in years. Wherever I end up after this, in whatever reality, all those moments between us were real, and they'll always be ours. No matter what you choose, I know you'll make the right decision.
Chloe, I can't make this choice.
No, Max. You're the only one who can.
So I can either save Chloe or sacrifice Arcadia Bay. So if I save Chloe, ultimately what I do is I stop myself from the first... if I sacrifice Chloe, I go back and I stop the first time I ever changed time. God damn. I mean, I this is where I thought it was all going. I was sure that this is where I was going to end.
Max, it's time.
Chloe, I'm so, so sorry. I don't want to do this.
I know, Max, but we have to. We have to save everybody, okay? And you'll make those fuckers pay for what they did to Rachel. Being together this week, it was the best farewell gift I could have hoped for. You're my hero, Max.
Oh, Chloe, I'm gonna miss you so much.
I'll always love you. Now get out of here, please. Do it before I freak. And Max Caulfield, don't you forget about me. Never.
So we're ultimately undoing the events of the entire five games.
It's cool, Nathan. Don't stress. You're okay, bro. Just count to three. Don't be scared. You own this school. If I wanted, I could blow it up. You're the boss. So what do you want?
I hope you check the perimeter, as my step-ass would say. Now, let's talk business.
I got nothing for you.
Wrong. You got hella cash.
You don't know who the fuck I am, or who you're messing around with!
Where'd you get that? What are you doing? Come on, put that thing down!
Don't ever tell me what to do! I'm so sick of people trying to control me!
You are going to get in hella more trouble for this than drugs.
Nobody would ever even miss your punk ass, would they?
Get that gun away from me, psycho!
Thank you.
Well, that's about the most explicit butterfly effect reference I've ever seen in anything without ever saying it. The first thing we ever did was take a photo of a butterfly, and flapping of the wings leads to a hurricane that destroys a town. That's like paraphrasing of like the butterfly effect example everyone always gives, and that was actually the plot of this 5-episode structure. And so, ultimately, we came to the conclusion, or at least I did in this playthrough, that the best thing to do was actually just to not use the power. We undid the first time I used it, and presumably never used it again from that point on. And we saved everyone. Not just the people that I was like, oh, maybe we can go back in time and save, Kate or Victoria. But no, we saved everyone except Chloe and, Amanda? Ashley? Crap. Every now and then I forget the name of the girl that we're actually looking for the entire time. To be fair, she's never in the game in person, unfortunately. But the town is saved at the cost of one last life. Someone who was going to die anyway, but we meddled with fate. That's pretty tough. If we ultimately save her, it means that everyone in the entire town dies because we're so stubbornly clinging to one person's life. Then how does she deal with that? Like, I was thinking about how I originally didn't want to tell her about letting her dad die so she could live, because I didn't, like, how would she deal with knowing that she was alive because her dad died? And then she would have been having to deal with the fact that she's alive because the entire, like, half the city dies. And what if that's not enough? What if this whole effect still keeps going even after she's dead? Like, if she's still alive but no one else is dead? Whoa, look at that. The text is backwards for the theme being backwards right there. Like, what if saving her doesn't actually save her? What if it keeps going after her forever, Final Destination style, until she's finally dead? It's hard to say. And of course, don't nod is a... not an anagram, it's a... whatever the word is for if you reverse a word, it spells the same thing. Don't nod, it's parallel. D-O-N-T-N-O-D, D-O-N-T-N-O-D. Alright, so this has been the 5th and final episode of Life is Strange. I'm curious to see if this developer is going to make a second season. Like, if they're going to come up with some other time travel storyline, or if they're going to make another episodic series from scratch. The way that Telltale is making more shows. Because I would like to see them do more. Their previous game was Remember Me. And I keep meaning to check that out someday. I think I actually own a copy of it. But that game was much less well-received, whereas this game, despite having a rocky start with the first episode where people weren't quite sure what to make of it yet, people have had really positive feedback for this entire series since then. And I would like to see where they go from here. So I enjoyed this little series, even if... it's interesting. Everyone... there's almost something satirical about this, that everyone obsesses over how much their decisions matter in episodic games and in story-driven games and Mass Effect and Dragon Age and Witcher and everything that Telltale makes. And the final decision in this game was whether or not to make all of your decisions not matter, to undo everything you did by playing the game and instead let fate play out the way it was already going to. A lot of elements of fate and faith and values of lives, and they even started playing with in the nightmare sequence with concepts of like whether or not time travel actually erases the time and lets you change things, or if you're just jumping between parallel universes, because even that character calls herself a Max that you left behind, like as if her timeline actually still just happens and you're just a consciousness jumping to alternate decisions. So they're just playing with the idea that there could be either one timeline that lives or a bunch of parallel timelines, and it's hard to tell. It's one of those unanswerable questions, because time travel's theoretical anyway, but even if it wasn't theoretical, how would you prove it? It's like the concept of, like, if you teleport in Star Trek, Are you actually moving from place to place instantaneously, or are you killing yourself and creating a new copy of yourself who thinks they're you and remembers being you, but is completely unaware that the consciousness that was left behind just ceased, and that they actually just started existing yesterday? Which also goes into that weird thought experiment of, like, what if the entire world formed in its current form, like, 10 minutes ago? How would you tell? And that kind of crazy concepts like that. I'm sorry, I'm just going down the sci-fi rabbit hole because that's what I love to do. I would say that, I probably could have done without some of the nightmare sequence stuff. I think that was an element of, Don't Nod trying to pad out the episode because the episode took so long to come out. Like, they probably wanted to have it a big, like, feature length, like, solid episode length to make it feel like it was worth it and everything. Because they were definitely just replaying of the events that happened throughout the game. And it got a little excessive, but that's just a minor criticism. But yeah, I enjoyed this. Thanks for watching, guys, like always, and I will see you next time. What's the percentages? Oh, wow. Wow. That's way more split than I thought it was going to be. I figured the majority of people would try to save Chloe. Makes sense. It's that ultimate decision of, like, you letting one person go and, like, letting go of your selfish clinging to one person to let an entire city live. But a surprising number of people let Arcadia Bay die. I wonder if that's... I wonder if that reflects any actual decisions people would make, or if that ultimately comes down to the video game nature. Because people aren't necessarily super attached to Arcadia Bay, but they have a lot of reason to be attached to Chloe because she's the number one character around the entire game. So maybe they just selfishly want to see Chloe live because the consequences aren't real. Oh. This is previous episodes. Is this the only episode? Oh, yeah. They're summarizing that as being the only decision in Polarize. And yeah, I guess it ultimately is. I would... I'm a little bummed out, though. I would prefer to... As fun as this is, it's nice to have it summed up like this, because it's the only decision that ultimately affects anything, because we undid the other decisions. But I would still want to know, like, who does and doesn't tell... Like, who does and doesn't tell the dad about Chloe being dead, for example, and getting the professor killed right there, and little decisions like that would be nice to know. But yeah, what's interesting there is, after we escaped the dark room, I was suspecting, like, what if, like, I was making decisions as if they still were going to matter, because even though our plan was to go back in time, I was still saying, like, what if what I'm doing right now still happens? Like, what if everything I'm doing over the course of this part of the game is actually still going to be canon? And yeah, if you choose to sacrifice Arcadia Bay, that would be the final version of the story for all those different characters, is what you did there, because you can't go back to undo it at that point. And maybe they live, maybe they die. Like, maybe some people live and some people die, and anyone who did survive, your decisions would have still carried on at that point. No sequel to this one. All right. I'm happy I played that.